following is an exclusive presentation of Jefferson Pilot Sports, a division of Jefferson Pilot Financial.
One is a member of the most famous SEC football family. The other is leading the new generation. Ole Miss's Eli Manning is in the final season of his record-breaking career, while Florida's Chris Leak passed his first test with a thrilling come-from-behind win last week. Their two teams meet today in the Swamp. It is a hot and humid day in legendary Florida Field at the Swamp, where over 90,000 fans have turned out to watch a big SEC game featuring this man, senior quarterback Eli Manning, take on true freshman quarterback Chris Leak. And it's all coming your way on our Jefferson Pilot SEC Game of the Week as 3-2 Florida takes on the 2-2 Ole Miss Rebels. And hello again, everybody. I'm Dave Neal. So glad you could join us once again. Boy, talk about two clubs that come into this one with different mindsets. How about Florida last week with their greatest road come-from-behind win in school history? They beat Kentucky 24-21, while Ole Miss is coming off a game in which Texas Tech threw for 661 yards. So this man, David Cutcliffe, has had to play the role of psychiatrist as opposed to a head football coach, but I guess sometimes that line gets blurred a little bit in today's society. But Dave Rowe, as we know what happened last week with this Ole Miss team, giving up so many points, so many yards, if you're Florida with a true freshman quarterback, what do you do? What's your game plan? Is it as obvious as we might think?
Well, you would think it would be. Florida's game plan all year, Dave, has been balanced, as evidenced by their run-pass ratio. And it's going to be tough for the Florida coaches and Chris Leak to not look at last week's 661 yards allowed by the Ole Miss defense and say, hey, we need to pass the ball all the time.
Well, I think one aspect that's been overlooked about Ole Miss this entire week is their offense. Let's face it, this offense can put points on the board. Eli Manning threw for over 400 yards last week, and 45 points usually gets it done. What do they have to do today offensively?
Well, Eli Manning is still the man. Their offense is averaging over 500 yards the last three games. But today, Eli realizes he's going to be tested. The strength of Florida's defense is in their secondary. He needs to realize he's not a one-man show. His receivers must catch the football, Dave, and he has to establish some sort of a running game.
Here inside the Swamp. And the third member, as always, our partner Dave Buzz Baker down on the sidelines. Buzz?
Hey, Dave, you know, one thing Ed Zonbrecker's tried to do is to make things as easy as possible for Chris Leak, and this his second start. You know where he gets a lot of help? The running back, Rand Carthon. He knows the offense so well that a lot of times what he'll do is he'll make the calls for Leak. He'll pick up things that the freshman quarterback doesn't have to worry about. He just has to worry about getting him into the right play, David.
Thank you very much, Buzz. Florida won the toss. They deferred, so Ole Miss will receive and have, or excuse me, Florida will receive. And the Gators will start from their own 20. So we have a touchback on the opening play. And Chris Leak, who came out and had a nice afternoon, specifically in the second half when he didn't get rattled when this team was down 21-3, and he's a true freshman, a lot to learn, but one thing is for sure, Dave, he rallied from what could have been a hard, difficult start.
Well, it was a difficult start because he was on the road, but the thing I noticed and I liked a lot about Leak last week is that he started off, he floated the ball, they were high, he corrected his mistakes and led his team to victory. That's what was important.
Chris Leak starting the shotgun like he did last week, and the handoff goes to Carthon around the left side, picks up 6-7 yards on the play. Travis Blanchard made the stop for the Rebels. Here's our Chevy starting lineups. Offensively for Florida, Carlos Perez last week, a huge game, 5 receptions, 102 yards, a couple of touchdowns. Up front, Max Darks, a little banged up, has a tweaked ankle, but should see plenty of snaps here today. This offensive line could be pretty good if they stay focused. Chris Leak fires Incomplete, just out of bounds. That was Carlos Perez who made the nice grab, but it will not count. Our Ole Miss starters defensively, this group up front, this front four really needs to get some pressure on the quarterback today. At the linebacker position, Justin Wade, been around the block a time or two. In the secondary, these guys are very fragile. Interested to see how they handle the first quarter of this game. If they give up a big play or if there's a long sustained drive, how fragile is their mentality at this point?
Absolutely. The first couple series here will really set the tone for that defensive secondary. Can they break up that passing combination?
On third down and a couple, handoff went to Carthon, and he'll be a little bit shy that first down. It'll bring up a fourth down and inches. So early on, what do you do if you're on Zook?
Well, I have enough confidence in my running game. I think you go for it. I mean, that's where you set the tune. But Ron Zook says, hey, we're going to punt it.
Well, the first big decision of the game. All he needed was about 6 inches.
Oh, he only has to make the 30-yard line. I bet he doesn't need 6 inches.
Eric Wilbur punts it away. That sails out of bounds. Not a great kick for Wilbur. It'll go out of bounds just shy of the 40-yard line. So Eli Manning will lead the charges out for the Ole Miss Rebels. And last week, what a performance by this young man. 29 of 49, three touchdown passes. Dave, he was overshadowed by defense, but that was an exceptional performance.
Absolutely. The thing I like about Eli Manning is he's consistent. He's always right there with his liberty. When he throws that football in, he has great confidence, and he leads. No one questions who the leader of Ole Miss is.
Out of the I formation. Little play action. Manning to throw. Looking up top. Has a receiver open. Mike Espy makes the catch at the 20-yard line. The sophomore from Madison, Mississippi, with a huge play that went 41 yards for the Rebels.
Well, it's an awkward pass. He's going to roll back out to his right, and watch when he sets up here. He's actually throwing off balance. Look how high the ball is. That ball is way up there. Good catch, good concentration by Espy. That is a huge play. Gus Scott just not there on the coverage.
Boy, Espy almost lost it. Good concentration. Espy's turned into their big play guy. Another fake to the corner of the end zone, looking for Collins. Overthrown. That'll bring up second down. Our Chevy lineup offensively for Ole Miss. Chris Collins, 26 straight games with receptions. Already holds some Ole Miss career receiving marks. We'll get into that a little bit later in the game. Up front, these guys are banged up. Justin Sawyer gets the start at center today for an injured Chris Spencer, who has a bad ankle. This entire lineup offensively, up front, I should say, we'll have to keep an eye on them. They are nit, to say the least. Four wide receivers. Manning across the middle, hits Espy. Gets about 4.5 on the play. Ratliff makes the tackle for the Gators. And here's that Florida defense. Ray McDonald, just a freshman up front. Darryl Lee, Mo Mitchell, Travis Harris. In the middle, you got Reed Fleming, Matt Ferrier, and Earl Everett. True freshman getting the start today. They've lost some serious talent in that linebacking corps. Those of you at home wondering what's going on with your picture, we're experiencing sunspots, which affect our satellite signal this time of the year. Most everybody that sends anything up through the satellite will have to deal with that, so we apologize. Flag down.
Boy, this could be a big flag. I wondered if the defense jumped offside. Darryl Dixon was the blitzer on that. Nope, going to go against Ole Miss.
There's our referee today, Jay Vines. Spoke with Jay before the game today.
Illegal formation. Against the offense, only 6 minutes on the line of scrimmage. It's declined. It'll be fourth down.
John Latina, the offensive coordinator for Ole Miss, says his offense performed extremely well in terms of numbers last week, but he says, you know what, when it mattered, we needed 6 points, we didn't get it. Yeah, so to me, it wasn't a great afternoon.
6-6 field goals last week. They wanted touchdowns last week.
Here's Jonathan Nichols, who's perfect this year. 33-yarder is good. Jonathan Nichols hasn't missed a kick a field goal or a point after all season long. He's 29 of 29, and Ole Miss with an early 3-0 lead on the road.
SEC football is being brought to you by Advance Auto Parts, by Citco, by Aaron Sales and Leasing, and by Chick-fil-A.
Eli Manning with a nice pass to open up Ole Miss's first drive that set up the Jonathan Nichols 32-yard field goal. Gives the Rebels an early 3-0 lead. Lee Rogers kicks it off for the second time. Andre Caldwell across the 20 to the 25-yard line. And that's where Florida will take over. Chris Lee comes back. Dave, but let's go back on that fourth down and short. What's your philosophy? I'm sure you've been with a lot of coaches that have made decisions like that, fourth and 6 inches early, first possession.
Well, and it's a good call that he made, punt the ball. I'm a defensive player, so I always like to go for it. I like to gamble. But you know what? I've got a good running back there in Carthen. I've got Deshaun. I mean, I want to see him run for it. I don't like giving the football up when it's fourth down and 2 or 3 inches to go.
On first and 10, and off to Carthon. To the 29, give him 4 on the play. You know, Dave, for this running game, it's got a good combination of Carthon and Deshaun Wynn. There's some other guys that get in the mix for Florida, but they're your basic two workhorses back there. But one interesting note about Carthon, his longest gain from scrimmage is only 15 yards. He's not a big play guy. He's a steady, durable back. You want the big play, you got to go to Deshaun Wynn.
Yeah, absolutely. Deshaun Wynn has been the one who's got that. He had a little ankle problem early in the year, but he's got that breakaway speed. He can take it the distance.
That'll be a Gator first down. Carthon out over the 36. Spotted at about the 38-yard line.
And Dave, this is a good mix. Look at Carthon take the football, come up through the hole, gets a nice block right there. I like him because he's a seasoned veteran. He's got a lot of years. He knows he's safe with the football. When you give it to him, he does something with it, and it's positive.
220-pounder out of Key West, Florida. Came in averaging 4.6 yards a carry. Flag is down on a reverse that goes nowhere to Carlos Perez. That was read by Daniel Booth, Josh Cooper.
Now, what's the flag? But that was good play by Ole Miss. They played the backside containment. You have to play your keys. Coaches always tell you have to play your keys. Offside in the neutral zone. Ouch. That's a stinger for Ole Miss. They just dropped him for about a 6-7 yard loss. Negate the whole thing. Bring it back down. And that's so easy to do. Get in that neutral zone, Dave. You're trying to crowd the ball. Get a good jump. Been there, done that.
Offsides against the defense. 5 yards. Repeat first down.
This is a reverse, but watch the backside containment right here. When he has nowhere to go when he gets the football. He almost dropped that ball. That ball almost came out.
Here's Ed Zonbrecher, the offensive coordinator for this Florida team. Had a good conversation with him yesterday. He's a great offensive mind. I love talking football with him. He kind of lays it out there to where even I can understand it. Hand off to Carthon across midfield, brought down by Wes Scott. That'll be another first down, a gain of 7 on the play.
Boy, nice misdirection play right here. You take the football, just fake it on the strong side, bring it back to Carthon. He finds a hole, gets to the outside, and does what he does best, use that speed.
And here's what Ed Zonbrecher was talking to us about, and that is getting to the line of scrimmage in a hurry so the defense can't make any changes. And on a hot day, that could be a factor before it's all said and done. Leak to throw. Pass is caught by Perez. He's a hit right at the 40-yard line. Vaughn Hutchins on the tackle for the Rebels.
Boy, and Vaughn Hutchins made up a lot of distance that time. He was playing way off the football. Right there. There's Vaughn Hutchins. Look how far off he's off the ball. Now, once that ball's thrown, close back. Excellent tackle. Got in there, wrapped him up.
5 rushes, couple of passes. Carthon already 32 yards. loses a yard there. Back to the 41-yard line. Nice play again defensively. Ken Burns, the junior from Monticello, Mississippi. Coach has told us, expect to see 45 in there today. Yep. He hadn't played a whole lot of snaps this year, but they needed somebody to make some plays, and old Ken stepped up. Third down and five. Leak, plenty of time, and Hutchins got there before the ball did. Kelvin Kite was the intended receiver.
Boy, Von Hutchins played this well. He knew exactly where Leak was going with the football. Got there a little bit too fast on Kite. But he had played it well if he had just hadn't bumped into him.
That's interference. On the defense, ball would be to spot the foul, automatic first down.
Let's see if we can see Von Hutchins. Number five. Here's the receiver coming across the field. Now watch this right in here. He gets through. Now there's Hutchins coming up on him. He just gets there too fast. He bumped into him. All he had to do is get that hand in front. You see his reaction to it. He saw that yellow flag come out.
Leak dodges one defender. Down the far side, off the fingertips of Rand Carthon, who's normally a reliable receiver out of the backfield. LP Spence was trying to keep up with Carthon.
Well, I was impressed with Leak's throw that time, Dave. He got flushed out of the pocket, had to move around in there, and he squares up. Now watch this, right on the fingertips, lay out there. Oh, that is so close. Good concentration. Gosh, I mean, that ball is right there. What you don't want to do, one thing that receivers have a problem with is that they start to stick out their hands early. You want to run as hard as you can and last second put out those arms to catch.
Second and 10. Leak to throw again. That's Kite. That should be good enough for a first down. Kelvin Robinson brings him down. That'll be a gain of 10 yards, and that will move the chains.
Dave, I see an immediate problem in that for Ole Miss, and that is no pressure on the quarterback. Look at Leak. Find that lane right there and throw to Kite. Kite's wide open. He just made a little curl pattern in the center. Just find an open space. They fanned those defensive linemen out, gave him a lot of room to look downfield. Ole Miss has got to get pressure.
Bad snap, but Leak falls forward for a couple of yards. That could have been trouble down here in field goal territory.
Absolutely. I don't think Leak even expected that ball. It just kind of snapped right to his stomach. They were fortunate.
Boy, Florida ran the ball considerably in the first few plays, and now they're going through the air. Mixing it up, you might say.
Well, if I had a Kelvin Kite and I had a Carlos Perez, I'd throw it too. And Ben Troop at tight end.
Flag down as Leak fires across the middle. Pass is caught. That'll be Kelvin Kite inside the 15. He'll hold everything.
What? Everybody hushes here in Florida Field.
Illegal formation. It's the offense. Only 6 men on the line of scrimmage. 5 yards. Repeat second down.
Florida came in as the ninth most penalized team in the SEC, giving up about 63 yards per game by way of the penalty.
You know, that's
their second today.
Dave, that's 6 men on the line of scrimmage. That's an interesting call. A lot of times it's that offensive tackle sitting back too far. I think that time it was the wideouts. I think there were two of them off the line, nobody up on the line.
There are 4 wideouts in the game right now for the Gators. Leak. Here's Carthon. Has a good block. Carthon down inside the 20 to the 16-yard line. Eric Oliver finally brought him down. And that will be a Gator first down.
Boy,
gain of 17.
Dave, no penetration. Nobody up in Leak space. Look at him standing back there. Now, watch number 72 get out here. That's Lance Butler. He gets a great block on Travis Johnson. Right in there, springs him back inside. But Ole Miss has got to get pressure. They've got to come with some kind of a package to get pressure on Chris Leak. You try to do it with your 4 down linemen, but sometimes you've got to bring a backer or two.
Marathon. Got a yard before brought down by Justin Wade and Josh Cooper. And that'll bring up second down.
This is an interesting play in that the backside comes all the way down across the line. When this ball comes off the ball, you see him coming down inside. Look how far he comes, all the way from the backside backer. Not supposed to do that. Justin Wade playing the play on that slant, running the line. That's a good play.
It's a 10-play drive right now for the Florida Gator offense. The 11th play, not too successful. Deshaun Wynn gets his first handoff and loses about 4 yards. Jesse Mitchell, the senior out of Moss Point, Mississippi, with the tackle.
Now that's disruption. When you get people in the backfield, you disrupt that running game, then you can get pressure on the quarterback if it's a pass. But you've got to break through that offensive line.
Here's a third down opportunity, or third down and 12 now for Florida. Leak in the shotgun. Kind of a quiet stadium right now. Some pressure coming. Ben Troop hurdles one defender down to the 5. Still on his feet. Troop will score. An unbelievable run from the tight end. 18 yards.
Well, when I watched the film yesterday, one of the things that I really liked about Troop is his strength. Look at the target he is. Never stops. And look at the number of missed tackles. But they did a lot of that in the last week's game. They run him out just a little bit, curl him around, and then give him the football, let him make it.
Matt Leach with the point after, and the Gators lead it by 4. We'll return after a word from your local station. SEC football is brought to you in part by Chevy Trucks. And Ben Troop with a nice touchdown reception and run with his second touchdown catch this year. Gives Florida the 4-point lead here in the first quarter. Troop against Tennessee in this stadium had a career-high 5 receptions for 106 yards. McClendon not over the 20 to the 22-yard line. Dave, let's go back to that touchdown. While it was a great run, let's face it, he was helped out.
Well, what they do is they run Troop right in there. Just a little circle pattern. Look, he squares up. Now, once he catches the football, watch Justin Wade, 51, come in here. He's going to have him. Bang, right there. Wow, he's run right through a tackle. That's what you want your tight end to do.
That is our Jiffy Lube well-oiled machine scoring drive. The longest touchdown drive of the season for Florida. 12 plays, 74 yards. Previous longest drive was a 10-play touchdown drive. Here's the handoff to Jermaine Turner. Check our Aaron scoreboard. And Virginia Tech on top of Rutgers 21-7. Western, wow. Over Minnesota.
That's a wow.
No second down and a long 4. For the Rebels in the I formation. Turner's your tailback. The play fake to him. And he rolls and fires. Pass is caught by Kerry Johnson. And that'll be a Rebel first down. Gus Scott brings him down.
Dave, if you're looking for positives for Ole Miss, one thing is their wide receivers have got to catch the football. That time, Kerry Johnson made a difficult catch. Up over his head, Espy made that earlier one. So his wide receivers are catching the football. That's one thing that Ole Miss has got to have.
Johnson with a couple of touchdown grabs this year. Last week against Texas Tech, Eli Manning found 12 different receivers. An audible at the line of scrimmage. Here comes some pressure. Manning fires quickly. Pass is caught on the outside by Bill Flowers, the junior from Pelham, Alabama. brought down by Johnny Lamar, the man who was Johnny on the spot last week in Lexington with the big interception that set up the go-ahead touchdown for Florida.
Well, I think Ole Miss is doing exactly what they need to on first down. Don't get in that second and long situation. Pick up 4 or 5 yards, get in that second 4 to 6 situation. Gives you a lot more options.
Second down and 6. 4 wideouts on the field. A little shovel pass. That goes to Brandon Jacobs. Charlie Strong, the defensive coordinator for the Florida Gators, returns home after spending some time with Lou Holtz in South Carolina, Notre Dame.
One of the most animated coaches you'll ever see on the sideline. Players love to play for him because he's not a yeller and a screamer. He's just a real encourager.
Third and short. Turner tries to bounce it to the outside, breaks a couple of tackles, and gets to midfield. That'll be a Rebel first down.
Well, now, Darryl Lee, 86, had him in the backfield and was going to stop him, but Turner kept those legs just driving. See if we see 86 come in here. He's got him in the backfield. Right in there. See how he's got him? Look at Turner. Never quits. Breaks through. Picks up that first down. Moves the chains.
Jermaine Turner with a 4.1 average this year. Ole Miss has made some definite improvements in the running game from a year ago when they ranked 112th in the country. Manning pump fakes. Goes up top. His receiver was held at the line of scrimmage. No flag. Just good defense from that secondary. Kerry Johnson, the intended receiver. Well, we mentioned it in the open about this Ole Miss offensive line. Dave Baker has more on that situation.
Dave, you got Trey Stallings, left tackle. He's got a bad wrist and a bad knee. Left guard Doug Buckles, right ankle. Chris Spencer's out with a bad ankle. Marcus Johnson, right shoulder sprain at the other guard spot. And then take a look at right tackle Cliff Woodruff. He's got what looks like a highly fortified oven mitt on his right hand. They call it a club. He's playing with a broken hand.
Here's Turner. And that banged up offensive line created a pretty big hole for Turner to pick up about 6 or 7 on the play. Darryl Dixon finally brings him down. But Tim Mullins, the head trainer over there at Ole Miss, Dave, was the busiest man in the state of Mississippi last Sunday.
He was. You know what I like on that play about Turner, Dave? That little side, little juke to the side where he just kind of sidestepped. He's got a bounce in the step. You're right, though. Gosh, that's like a mass unit over there. They said every offensive lineman was in the training room. There you see Woodruff's hand. You see that right hand all bandaged up.
Woodruff, 300-pounder out of Oxford, Mississippi. Third down, Manning to throw. He's going for it all. Collins was bumped out of bounds as he ran down the sidelines. Kewon Ratliff on the coverage. That'll fall incomplete. Dave, fourth down. Here you are at about the 43. What do you think? Take a shot at it?
Boy, you'd like to punt him deep. You'd like to get him inside the 10, 15-yard line. That's what David Cutcliffe would like to do.
Let's check in with Buzz.
Dave, it seems like Florida's made a real decision to get really physical with Collins. Kewon Ratliff, the last two plays, he is really bumping him every step of the way. They don't want him to get free out on the pattern.
I thought, really, Dave, I thought that when he was coming downfield, I thought he got interfered. He got shoved out of bounds about 15 yards off the line of scrimmage. I was surprised with that. Well, he got it down.
Ridgeway's punt sails into the end zone. Florida will take over at the 20, a 42-yard kick, but it will net only 22. 7-3 Florida. 14-3 is our score. The Florida Gators with a nice-looking drive. Again, their first drive went 12 plays. Their longest touchdown drive of the season, and that drive certainly highlighted by a nice Chris Leak pass down to the 5-yard line. And then set up the leak to O.J. Small touchdown pass that covered 5 yards. McClendon will take it at the 10. McClendon will give Ole Miss the football at the 30-yard line. Fans, JPSports.com has the coverage you want. No one knows the SEC like JP Sports, and we bring the information to you online. Tune in each week for previews of upcoming games, broadcast information, and many other exciting features. JPSports.com brought to you by the Rechargeable Battery Recycling Corporation. Just shy of the 30. Manning under center in the I formation. Doing on that handoff. Deshaun Pearson was clobbered by a bunch of blue jerseys at the line of scrimmage.
You're right, nowhere to go. Good penetration. The defensive line getting off in there. McDonald, Harris getting off, getting penetration. Look right here. Nowhere to go. They meet him in the backfield, 2 yards in the backfield. If I'm a defensive player, that's what you like. That's what Charlie Strong likes. Defensive penetration.
There's Ray McDonald, the freshman out of Belgrade, Florida. He has been a real pleasant surprise on that defensive front. Here comes some pressure. Manning escapes it. It's his fullback out over the 30. Brandon Jacobs gets a couple on the play. Boy, Eli Manning just will not take a sack. He's only been sacked 6 times this year.
Well, when he gets that pressure in his face, he throws the ball because he's got such great vision. Then when he rolls out there, he's always looking downfield. He's fearless. He's not the fastest of foot, but they really need this one. This is third down. Florida has taken the momentum back in the football game. They need a big play if you're an Ole Miss fan. If you're a Florida fan, listen to this crowd get in. They know they need a defensive stop.
Third down conversions today, 1-4. They came in third best in that department in the SEC, converting about 42.5% of the third downs. Manning fires. Pass is caught over the 45 to the 47-yard line by Mike Espy. Ratliff on the coverage.
Nice route that Espy runs. Just a post pattern. Come down the field. Now come down the field, come underneath, and watch him just cut across in the middle, right in there. Be a big target. He makes gets those hands out in front of him, looks that ball in. That is as well as you can coordinate between a quarterback and a wide receiver.
Hard to stop that kind of play when the quarterback and receiver are certainly clicking. Big hole for McClendon. McClendon inside the 30. McClendon to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Ronald McClendon. A 52-yard scamper, no flags on the play.
Dave, that's exactly what Ole Miss needed. They had to score. They had to get some points. McClendon virtually goes in untouched. Good up block right there, but he's in the secondary. Now make one man miss, and he does make that one man. Bailey missed. Now outrun him. He went in untouched.
Went after his up man, good by Jonathan Nichols. And how about the banged up offensive line at Ole Miss, letting McClendon run for a 40-yard pickup and then a 52-yard pickup. And how about the per average, 31.3.
Well, watch the hole right here that develops. Good block right there, good block right there. There's nothing there. Look at this, burst into secondary, make one man miss. He does, that's Bailey, number 7. Now just run to the end zone. He's running out, running the secondary, and that's the strength of Florida's defense.
Well, Ronald McClendon, the senior college transfer, has been bothered by a bad hamstring this year and really hasn't gotten cranked up. He put on 15 pounds from a year ago in this running game that was 12th in the Southeastern Conference, averaged 94 yards a game. That's what McClendon has right now.
Yeah, I know, on three carries.
They came in averaging 151 yards on the ground, and Ron Zook trying to make sure his team stays focused. He really got after his bunch last week in Lexington, perhaps his most animated halftime discussion with the ball club. And when you talk to the players, they said they felt like they kind of needed it.
Yeah, he's a very animated coach, as you said. He's a player's coach. He gets right in their face, and he can motivate you.
Let's check in with Dave Baker. Buzz, what do you have?
Dave, interesting on that last drive. Remember what Charlie Strong told us yesterday? He said he wanted his defense to make the opposition offense one-dimensional, and he said he wanted Eli Manning to have to throw the football. He was concerned about Ole Miss getting the ground game cranked up, and they certainly did on that series.
Florida will bring it out to the 20. Well, for the most up-to-date information on the 2003-2004 Southeastern Conference basketball season, look for the long-standing authority on college basketball, Street & Smith. Pick up your copy of the all-new fact-filled Street & Smith's SEC preview, now available at newsstands throughout the South. Big news in this part, Mario Bogan, 6'6", 290-pound forward post player for the Gator basketball team, has decided to transfer. It was announced yesterday. Said he needed some more playing time, and 6'6", 290, we know Billy Donovan loves to get it up and down the floor, and I don't think 6'6", 290 can get it up and down the floor like Coach Donovan needs it to. A flag down at about the 20-yard line.
Yeah, Dave, that's what discouraged me from playing basketball. 290, yeah. Running them boards every day back and forth.
Dead ball. Ball start. It's the offense moving an offensive line. 5 yards. Lane's first down.
Aaron's scoreboard. Virginia Tech putting it on Rutgers. Minnesota storms back. They were down 16-0 in that contest. Michigan State winning. And the Yellow Jack. I cannot figure this Georgia Tech team out. They are the enigma of college football right now. Play action to Carthon. Leak will throw it. Through the hands of Kelvin Kite, a little bit high. Von Hutchins on the coverage.
And Dave, you know what Leak did that time? He did the same problem that he had in Kentucky. He floats the ball. He has a tendency to kind of soft it in there. See the trajectory of the ball? That ball needs to be delivered. It needs to be a strike. But again, see how high he has to go up for the football? He's wide open. You throw it in there with velocity, and he'll learn that as he becomes more seasoned in this league.
He was wide open, all right. So was his rib cage had he made that.
Yeah, it's true.
Second down and 15 now. Trying to set up a screen. They do so. Some room for Carthon to the 25-yard line. A gain of 10 on the play. That'll bring up a third down and 5. Travis Blanchard in on the tackle for Ole Miss.
Well, if you want to play at Florida, you have to be multidimensional, and that means you have to be able to catch the football. Carthon runs in like he's going to block, then slips out into the flat. He's just a scooter runner. Look how light his feet are to the ground. They just stay right at the ground. He's picking up yardage. He doesn't take that big high stride. He picks up positive yardage.
Carthon is an excellent receiver out of the backfield. I think that one of the reasons he has an edge over Deshaun Wynn, not only is he a senior, but he's got great hands out of that backfield. Flags are down on both sides of the line of scrimmage. Looking for Ben Troop, but through his hands. Wow, that was right in the old breadbasket, and Ben just flat out dropped it.
Well, you know what I thought that time? I thought Ben Troop just took his eye off it, that the old proverbial try to run before you catch it, because that was right there. Good quarterback pressure in there. Josh Cooper, number 99, with the pressure, but the play was going to be negated anyway.
Illegal formation. Gets the offense. Has declined. And fourth down.
I'll tell you what, talk to Jay Vines before the game today. He's out of Birmingham. I'll finish the story in just a second.
Well, again, you see Josh come in here with the pressure. Gets the pressure on him right in there. Now, flush him out of the pocket. Now, Troop, look at this. He's got that ball. That ball is, that's just not like him. He's too good.
Well, Jay Vines, the referee, lives in Birmingham, and he said it's nice to do these early games. I can get back home. Well, the rate they're throwing these flags today, none of us will get home. Wilbur's punt is end over end, line drive. That bounces and takes a favorable kick. Nice job after the high snap just to get the punt off. Well, next week it should be a dynamite contest from Fayetteville, Arkansas. The Auburn Tigers still in the race for an SEC championship will take on the Arkansas Razorbacks, a team that has surprised the nation. Carlos Dansby, one of the great defenders in college football, will try to get his hands around Cedric Cobbs, who is third in the nation in rushing yards per game at 140 yards a contest. Cannot wait to get to Fayetteville next week.
Yeah, nobody's touched Cobbs so far. They've seen the back of his jersey.
McClendon hit at the line of scrimmage. Reed Fleming, the senior from Panama City, Florida, makes the tackle. And while we're looking at Reed, it gives us a chance to kind of explain what's happening in that linebacker corps for Florida today. Dwight Jackson is out. Bad shoulder. Got hurt on that great catch by the Kentucky tight end last week. Also out, Channing Crowder. He's out at least a month. And then Todd McCullough, a couple of weeks ago, hurt his shoulder, and he's out for the season after surgery. So they don't exactly have a lot of depth at linebacker for the Gators. Chris Collins makes the catch, gets upfield in a hurry, and picks up a first down. Heady play by the senior wideout.
Boy, good throw by Eli Manning. Just a dart. Throw it in there. It needed to be delivered quickly. Coverage was back about 5 to 7 yards. You throw it out there quickly, let him make the yardage to pick up the first down. Right now, if you're Ole Miss and you can score in this situation, you put a lot of pressure on Florida.
Well, that keeps the streak alive for Chris Collins. He's now caught a pass in 27 straight games. Manning. Here's Collins. Inside Gator territory to the 42-yard line. Johnny Lamar makes the tackle along with Earl Everett.
Dave, every quarterback has got one of those go-to receivers, and I think that's what Chris Collins is with, along with Eli Manning. He's just one of those guys that you can just always know he's going to catch the football.
25 catches coming into this game. And Jamal Pittman, the freshman from Columbia, Mississippi, into the football game for the first time today. Pittman gets 9 on the carry. Pittman is a guy, is a high school senior, ran for over 3,000 yards, had 36 touchdowns, but blew out his knee in spring practice and worked his tail off to get back ready for this football season and just now getting healthy. But coaches says, you know, here's a guy that can play, but he doesn't know everything we're trying to get accomplished offensively yet, and that slowed him down.
Absolutely. They know he's got the running ability. They're concerned about the pass blocking and the blocking carrying on out those routes on the pass pattern. But he's a runner.
Follows his blockers. Gets a couple on the play. He's a big boy at 6'2", 240 pounds as your tailback.
Dave, he's got a great lean when he runs. That's what you look at a running back. Do they run straight up or do they have that lean? They have that lean, they get in there, and when they get hit, they get those extra yards.
Well, David Cutcliffe told us one of the things about Jamal is that really when he's in the game, we've got to use him. We've got to run so teams can pretty much know in advance what we're trying to do and accomplish offensively. Manning just throws it away.
Dave, there's a good example of why he doesn't get sacked. He throws the ball away. Now, was there a hit to the face mask? Or was he grounding it? Yes, grounding.
Well, he dropped straight back, and he didn't get outside that, quote, tackle box. There's two parts to that. You got to get outside the tackle box, and you have to get the ball across the line of scrimmage. He only got half of it right.
Additional grounding on the offense. The ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. Loss of down. Second down.
This is a good you did a great job explaining that you have to throw it, you have to be out of the pass blocks, which he was not, and you have to break the line of scrimmage. Look at Archie. Son, you can't do that. Or maybe he didn't like the call, huh, Dave?
Third down and 16. Steps up, fires, picked off. Matt Ferrier down at the Ole Miss 45. first interception for the senior from Petersburg, Virginia, 27-yard return.
Well, what Barrier did is he knew that slant pattern. He knew that Manning has gone to that slant pattern. There he is, number 43. Great picture of him. Watch him read the quarterback's eyes. Manning looks offside. Now he comes in and zeroes in. And look, him just slide right in front. Great catch, too. Good hands. Out in front of the body. Now he knows what to do. So, again, watch him just step right in front. Perfect. Just play the quarterback's eyes. Knew that slant pattern was coming.
Here's Deshaun Wynn. Cuts it back. Spins. Inside the 35. Down to the 34-yard line. Brought down by Travis Blanchard, but not before the redshirt freshman picks up a Gator first down.
Well, that's an interesting play right there. I watched that play yesterday as we look at Barrier from the interception. But I watched that play yesterday, Dave, where they run that misdirection. It's really interesting. He actually runs against the grain and waits for the tackle to come around and lead him.
It's about four on the carry. Well, in terms of the SEC's lowest percentage of interceptions, David Green of Georgia right now leading all quarterbacks that have ever suited up in this conference. Of course, David Green still has some snaps to take, as does Eli Manning, as that is our Chick-fil-A nugget of the game. I mean, it is amazing. This year, he's thrown four interceptions. That'll be his fifth that he just threw to Ferrier, but 11 touchdowns on the air. Leaks pass, caught by Troop, hurdles another Ole Miss defender. If this guy didn't run the hurdles in high school, he should have.
Man, that is amazing. There's Troop right there, number 84. Now watch, he's going to run a crossing pattern and just find the open seam. See how he just pops out right there? He's a big target. Then he jumps over top of people.
Gators quickly to the line of scrimmage. 2:01 to go in the second quarter. Here's Deshaun Wynn. Stutter steps inside the 15. Down to the 17-yard line.
Ole Miss in this situation, you've got to be thinking stop them to a field goal. If you're Florida, you want to take the momentum back, go into the locker room with a positive note, get 7 points. David Cutcliffe knows he needs a stop.
Well, the Gators lead the Southeastern Conference with 57 points off of 15 turnovers. Now plus 5 in the turnover department after being minus 9 a year ago. Leak under pressure. Oh. I'll tell you what, that should be granted because I don't think he got outside the tackle box as well. Pressure came from Charlie Anderson.
It's the exact same thing. You're right, Dave. He didn't get out of the tackle box, and he did not break the line of scrimmage when he threw the ball. The ball almost broke the line of scrimmage, but it did not. Intentional grounding.
Intentional grounding. It's the offense. Ball will be placed to spot the foul. Lost down. It'll be third down.
Well, what great pressure by Ole Miss that time. They come hard pressure inside, outside. Everybody's coming, trying to get them, and they're trying to force a mistake. Now, right there, don't let him step back inside. You see him throw the ball. The stakes, he didn't break the plane of the stakes, hence the grounding.
Late to throw. Troop catches it at the 25. He'll be well shy of the first down. He mixes it up over there with Kelvin Robinson.
Now the fans want that hit out of bounds, but Robinson actually was just, he was just riding on Troop. Troop, a big player. Got great hands. Look at the concentration. Catches away from his body. Now when Robinson hits him right there, he's not trying to throw him to the ground. In fact, Troop never hits the ground. See right in here? That's just driving out of bounds. Now he's falling. They were complaining about that, but he was just falling.
Here's Matt Leach from 36 yards. Kick is up, and it is perfect. So Florida adds to their lead, 17-10, 1:05 to go before halftime. Stay with us. We'll return after these messages from the SEC.
A day in the life of the University of...
I don't think that's what we had planned. Leach with the field goal for Florida, giving the Gators a 7-point advantage. All right, let's try that one more time.
A day in the life of the University of Florida. University of Florida, celebrating 150 years of excellence.
17-10, just 105 remaining before intermission. A little different scenario for the Gators than last week, that they went into the locker room trailing 14-3. Ronald McClendon and Sean Pearson back to return the Florida kickoff. Will take a knee. And with a minute 5 left, you come out to the 20. What do? Just try to get to the locker room or try to move it down the field?
Well, two schools of thought. You don't want to make a mistake. You've just made a mistake and you've given momentum back to Florida. But then again, you want momentum. So see what he does on first down. See if he comes back. If he can complete a pass on first down, maybe he might try to move the stakes quickly.
Eli Manning, 9 of 16 for 105 yards. Does have that one interception. Hand off to McClendon. Gets a couple on the play.
Well, that answered that question. They're just happy to go to locker room because they're not in any hurry up on offense, so they're just willing to run the clock down.
Ole Miss does have three timeouts left. But apparently they are content to regroup. Ole Miss will get the football to start the second half. Florida with a couple of timeouts. Here's delay handoff to McClendon. Tries to get the corner. Ronald McClendon out to the 29-yard line. That'll bring up a third down and one.
Yep, nobody hurrying. Just content. Hey, you're playing here. In the Gator Stadium, they're so successful here. You're down 17-10. Don't take a chance.
And that will do it for the first half of football. We've got a good one here in Gainesville. 24th-ranked Florida Gators lead David Cutcliffe's Ole Miss Rebels 17-10 from the Swamp in Gainesville. Florida seeking a little bit of revenge after Ole Miss beat the Gators in Oxford just a year ago, 17-14. Dave Baker is down on the sidelines. Let's check in with him.
Ron, you got a big play on defense there at the end of the half, and your guys made some really big plays on offense.
We're going to have to continue to do that. We got to clean. We can't have the penalties that we're having right now. We got to clean that stuff up, and we just got to keep playing. It's going to be a long. A lot of ball to be played yet.
All right, Coach. Thanks. It's Ron Zook. He goes to the locker room as his Florida Gators lead the Rebels of Ole Miss. We're back at the Swamp right after this.
SEC football is brought to you by Chick-fil-A, by Gatorade, by Crystal, and by Advance Auto Parts. SEC football is being brought to you by Regions Bank, by Sonic Drive-In, by Jiffy Lube, by Taco Bell, and by Napa Auto Care Centers.
It is a hot day. There are plenty of fans in the seats and plenty of fans with fans here in Gainesville, Florida. As the Florida Gators lead Ole Miss 17-10 as we get set for second half football. Eli Manning in the first half, 9 of 16, 105 yards. Chris Leak, 12 of 17, 183 yards and a couple of touchdowns. Pretty good numbers by the true freshman out of Charlotte, North Carolina. Ole Miss will get the football first as we begin second half play. This kick will be returnable. Here's McClendon. McClendon out over the 25, drives his way to the 30-yard line. Good return for the man they call Goldie. Ole Miss's average starting position has been about the 28-yard line today. Dave, Eli Manning, 9 of 16 for one interception. Last year against this Florida team, he only had 154 yards passing, his lowest total as a starter at Ole Miss. What is Florida doing to disrupt Eli?
Well, they're reading his eyes, of course. They're trying to put some pressure on, but they've got a strong defensive secondary. That's the strength of their defense. There's a good hard count. Draw him off sides. Good call.
Right out of the gate.
Pick up a free 5 yards.
And we see the yellow flag.
Dead ball. Offsides against the defense. 5 yards. Manning's first down.
Looked like Ray McDonald. Guilty party there.
Go with them.
Here are our quarterbacks today. And the comparison in those numbers.
Yep. And it's an interesting comparison because there are two quarterbacks in different stages of their career. One just starting and one
a couple of yards in the play to Deshaun Pearson. Reed Fleming makes the tackle along with Earl Everett. Everett, the true freshman out of Webster, Florida. 6'2", 210. They say this guy is going to be a stud linebacker in the Southeastern Conference. The problem is he's a true freshman, and you got to live with a lot of mistakes that he might make in terms of being in the wrong spot.
But hustle always outweighs mistakes, just as long as you're playing hard.
Another flag is down on second and about 3.5. Sean Pearson tackled by Ray McDonald.
Well, if that's six men on the line of scrimmage, David Cutcliffe is going to scream.
Here's Jay Vines with the call.
Illegal formation. Gets the offense. Only 6 men on the line of scrimmage. That's declined. It'll be third down.
Boy, John Latina behind David Cutcliffe, who also coaches the offensive line as well as he's the offensive coordinator.
No smile on that man's face.
John Latina's a pretty big boy.
Yes, he is. I don't want him mad at me.
Down and two. Manning up top, lofts it up in the air through the hands of Daryl Dixon, who had a chance for the interception, looking for Eric Rice. Saw earlier this season he's got a bad ankle that's been bothering him since preseason practice, and he just doesn't have the giddy up that he used to have.
Exactly. Not a pattern deep. You see him read the Dixon reads the eyes of the quarterback and comes over. But you're right, Eric Rice, just with that hobbled ankle, it's just like a thoroughbred that has that little nick. He just doesn't have that speed coming off the line.
Ewan Ratliff back to return the Cody Ridgeway punt. Ratliff leading the Southeastern Conference in punt return average at 14.5 per return. Here's a pretty good kick that'll send Ratliff down to the goal line, and it bounces out of bounds just inside the 2-yard line. What a kick from Cody Ridgeway. A 60-yard punt that goes out of bounds at the 2. Well, football fans, register for your chance to win $1 million in the Bell South Kick for a Million contest. One lucky fan will be given the opportunity to kick for $1 million during halftime of the 2004 Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl in Atlanta on January 2nd. Log on to jpsports.com to register and then start practicing your field goals. Bell South, listening, answering.
Well, partner, I'm ready to answer your question now. What does Ole Miss's D have to do? Got to get pressure on them. Got to stop them up front. Don't let them run outside.
Couple on the play for Rank. What did you think of the Ole Miss defense in the first half?
Well,
will you answer that
all
question,
right, I'm
please?
Answering that. I'm answering that. I thought it was pretty good. I really did. Knowing the talent that Florida has, They can go deep on you all the time. I thought that they completed a lot of long passes. But I thought their defense really held in there. I really did.
And, you know, they did give up some big plays, Dave. But
sure.
Their players were in the right spots. They just didn't make the plays.
Exactly. There were a couple plays could have gone the other way.
Hand off to Tarthon. He loses a yard on the play. Jesse Mitchell, the senior out of Moss Point, Mississippi, one of the leaders of this defense, makes a big play for the Rebels.
Boy, good line play here up front. You've got to be able to stop them quick. You've got to get penetration. Now watch, in here, get upfield, come upfield, get penetration, get out here, stop it quick. When he gets out there, look right there. He's standing right in front of him, Jesse Mitchell. That's penetration. Penetration causes disruption in the backfield.
Al Groh, the Virginia head football coach, repeatedly told that to us earlier this year. Defensively, you have to cause disruption. Leak trying to cause some offensive disruption. Pass is caught by tight at midfield. A 46-yard reception for the Gators, and they dig themselves out of a big hole. Von Hutchins was on the coverage.
Well, the route is a go pattern. You come off the line, watch Kite. Just try to get in front of him. Look at this. He just beat him. Use that speed. Now, right here, he accelerates and comes out. Good look at the ball. Just perfectly thrown. That's, again, Von Hutchins. He's a good cornerback. That's just an outstanding throw. But, again, Ole Miss elected just to rush four linemen. Didn't get any pressure. Leak was able to stand back there.
Boy, that would have been a nice start for the Ole Miss defense instead. Gators on the move. Flag down at the line of scrimmage. Pass is caught at the 30-yard line. That's enough for the first down. Vernell Brown, the sophomore, makes the grab. So we'll wait on the call.
Well, we've seen flag after flag after flag, Dave, but not enough men on the line of scrimmage.
This is amazing to me. I'd like to get a shot.
Illegal formation against the offense. Only 6 men on the line of scrimmage. 5 yards. Repeat first down.
Dave, this is amazing.
Yeah. Well, what it is, it's two positions where it happens. Either the offensive tackles are sitting too far deep on the pass pattern trying to get off the ball, or else you got a wide receiver that's not up close enough to the line of scrimmage.
First down and 15.
Looks good to me on that play. I'm just looking across the line.
Here's the handoff. Big game for Rand Carthon. Inside the 15. A game of 53.
Dave, this is that misdirection play. I watched it yesterday. You see the tackle coming on the backside there. That's the key block. Kick out the outside backer. And Carthon just actually takes that little dodge step to the right, comes back against the grain and follows his tackle through the hole.
Florida knocking on the door. First and goal. This drive started at their own 2-yard line. A handoff to Carthon, and he has met Ken Borns. But Carthon with a couple of big plays in this game early, and now a couple of big plays here in the second half.
Yeah, I like his vision into the hole. He's got excellent vision. He finds that little seam, makes the step. If it's not there, he bounces to the outside. He's got those quick feet. They're on the ground. We talked about him being an outstanding receiver. He's just a well-rounded player, can do anything that Florida asks him to do.
12 carries, 81 yards today for Rand Carthon. Leak to throw. Looks right now, looking left. Ruth throws out of bounds over everybody's head.
Oh, and a late flag. Flag was a dead ball penalty. It was after the play was over, Dave.
Ole Miss pointing. Now they're declining the penalty. Illegal receiver downfield. That'll bring up a third down and goal from the 12 if it's declined.
Eligible receiver downfield on the offense. That's declined. Be third down.
Big down here. You've just driven the football a long way. You don't want to make a mistake in here. Chris Leak, a lot of pressure on him.
He's got four receivers in the game, three to the top, one to the near side. Carthon stands to Leach right in the backfield. Third and goal from the 12. Pressure coming. Leach goes down at the 20. Vaughn Hutchins with his first sack of the season, the senior.
This is actually a cornerback sack. Vaughn Hutchins is the cornerback, and where he's going to come from is way on the outside. Nobody, look at him just flying in there. He's coming from his cornerback spot. That's what they needed to do on that one long one. They needed pressure.
37-yard attempt coming up for Matt Leach. He's been good from 36. And that misses wide right. Ole Miss gave up a couple of big plays, but it didn't matter. The defense held when it mattered. We'll return to Gainesville after this. SEC football is brought to you in part by Toyota. Third quarter football from the Swamp in Gainesville. Florida leads Ole Miss 17-10. 10-11 to go in the third quarter. The Florida Miss field goal gives it back to the Rebels at the 20. Hand off left guard. Loose football. Bailey tries to get it for the Gators, but Ole Miss will recover it. What a big break for the Ole Miss Rebel offense. LaShawn Pearson just had the ball stripped out of his left hand.
He was stretching for that extra yard, trying to get that extra yard or two, and right in here he gets the ball pulled out. And compliment Florida for ripping that football out. But how about Townsend going in there? And I think he's the one right there who recovers it. Good heads-up play.
Townsend, the fullback, the junior out of Monticello, Mississippi, for the heads-up play. Now an offsides against the Gator defense. Mo Mitchell, big number 61, the guilty party. Well, Dave, I got kind of tired of talking to you, so I decided I needed to talk to somebody else. So I brought in the commissioner.
Somebody who'd answer your question.
Mike Slive joins us up here. Welcome. Turns out we've got a pretty good football game.
We've got a great football game here going on, and this game is a long way from being over. It's a great one.
Yeah, we have been fortunate. Last week we had that Florida-Kentucky game, which certainly kept our audience, in front of their televisions. We had a couple of overtime games. Actually, three of them last week,
yeah.
First and 10, ball in the 33. Manning changing the play. Play clock at 7. Over the middle, pass is caught by Flowers across the 40. He will be a couple of yards shy. We're getting into conference play now, Commissioner, and this is always a great time of the year. I mean, it's just the passion that people begin to. There have been some great non-conference matchups, but there's something special about these league games.
Yeah, you know, when I get on the road and I get into a stadium like this, there isn't a seat in the house. We're going to have it everywhere all weekend long, and it's just there's just nothing like SEC football. I don't care what you're talking about. This is the best.
Ask you a question about that non-conference schedule in just a moment. Here's the handoff to Pearson. He'll be shy of the first down. That'll bring up third down. This has been a unique couple of years for every major college football team with 12 games scheduled due to the way the calendar situation has been situated. What do we do about the future? Are we going to be going back to the 11-game schedule for an extended period of time again?
Well, as you know, the 12-game schedule is sort of an accident of the calendar, Dave, when there's an extra weekend in the tournament. But we probably won't be making those decisions until we finish up with the postseason and the BCS and all of that.
As a fan, I like the 12th game. Do I get a vote?
So do I. Thank you. Yeah.
Third and 2. Here's the handoff off the left side. Pearson will pick it up at the 45-yard line. That's just hard running from the tailback over the left side. Ferrier brings him down.
Boy, you have to credit the fullback on this. Just come off the line. Big man on big man smash. Trying to hook him inside. Really important that you hook that outside man there. Drive him off. And they did. That was Lawrence Lilly, the tight end, who hooked him, got him, got the first down.
That Ole Miss offensive line is just gutting it out today. Every one of those players is injured in some capacity. I know a lot of players in college football this time of the year are injured, but those guys spent all day Sunday in a training room just trying to move around. Another good run by Pearson into Florida territory. And Commissioner, I know we're in the middle of football season, but We just read a promo for basketball season. I mean, it's a couple of weeks away. Here we go again. I mean, it's just never ending. This is, I think this is one of the reasons that I think the Southeastern Conference is so special. When you look around, and you know, here, Billy Donovan's got a great program returning. What's the best part of this for you?
The best part is right now. You know, it doesn't matter whether it's football or basketball day, but just being in and watching the kids play and having our fans here and not worrying about other issues, this is the best part.
Amen to that. Second down and four. Here's Pearson again. He breaks through the hole, and that'll be a first down. Dave, this offensive line is just getting it done right now. I mean, it's they're creating a lot of space for the entire running back core of Ole Miss.
Well, I call it smash mouth football. It's big man on big man, and Pearson just finds that little seam. He followed his fullback up in there. Look at that cast.
Cliff Woodruff has that broken hand.
That's tough, Commissioner, when you got a broken hand and he taped it up and he's out there.
He's out there playing.
Yeah.
Ronald McClendon takes the handoff. He replaces Pearson. It's a seventh straight rush by this Ole Miss defense. Well, Commissioner, I needed a break from Dave Rowe for a couple of minutes. I just want to say thanks for stopping by. Always a pleasure. And now you may be heading to another game tonight, but hopefully we'll have the best one of the day right here.
Well, thanks. And you guys had a great one next week, too, so we look forward to watching it with you.
Always a pleasure to see you.
Thanks, Dave.
Commissioner
thanks
Mike Slive
Dave,
of the Southeastern Conference. Next week, he's referring to the Arkansas-Auburn game over in Fayetteville, Arkansas. There's Charlie Strong, defensive coordinator, trying to find a way to stop this Ole Miss, dare I say it, rushing attack. Pearson inside the 30. That'll be another first down.
Boy, what a block by Brandon Jacobs, the fullback, leading in the hole. I mean, we're talking about just put your head down. And for David Cutcliffe, he's saying, we're just going to control this ball on the ground. Watch Jacobs, 27. He leads right in there. Get that block out there. And then Pearson read the cut, make positive yardage, pick up the first down and move the chains.
For the best deals on cars, trucks, and SUVs, visit your local Toyota dealer today. Look at the play selection from Ole Miss today. Not in a million years would I have imagined that.
A lot of audibles on the line.
Another handoff. McClendon stuck right at the line of scrimmage. Johnny Lamar steps up with his fifth tackle to lead that Gator charge. Dave, Ole Miss has 179 yards on 22 carries today. And only 113 yards through the air.
Well, what they're doing is they're controlling the game with the running game. It's worked for them. McClendon had an excellent first half. They can control the tempo of the game. They're keeping the clock running, moving the chains, doing everything they need to do to win this football game.
They've stalled right here a couple of times already today. Manning. Over the middle. Espy with the catch inside the five. He dropped the football. Who's got it? The Gators have the football. Corey Bailey with the fumble recovery.
Dave, it's a post pattern in traffic. Espy's coming from the left of your screen. He's going to cut into the middle. Watch him go up, but you've got to get the ball back into your body. What Florida just outstanding right there. Gus Scott, I think, is the one who pulls it out. You tackle the ball.
Was he down is my question.
Oh, that's a close one. I think it was coming out, though. I think that the ball was coming out. But credit Gus Scott for pulling that football out.
I'd like to look at that one more time if we get an opportunity here in a moment. Tom Smith, our director, is probably cussing me out right now. But I'd like to see it one more time. That was close. Backed up. The Gators running. Sean Wynn out to the 9-yard line. Gain of 7 on the play. For the best deals on cars, trucks, and SUVs, visit your local Toyota dealer today. Second down and 3 now. That'll bring up a third down and 1 after Wynn picks up maybe a yard and a half. Here's a couple of more looks at that play.
Well, what has to be down is a part of his body other than the feet. Now watch when his tail hits the ground. Right there. That ball was started out. That's an outstanding shot right there. Again, credit the defense for pulling the ball out, but he's not down. You see how the ball's coming out right there?
That is close. And the Gators will pick up the first down because Jesse Mitchell jumped the gun.
Hard counts will get you every time on defense. You just get used to that cadence. Quarterback comes out, says his number, set, hut, hut, hut. He comes out and emphasizes.
This may go the other way. Let me stop a second. Jesse Mitchell did jump the gun, but Lance Butler may have pulled the trigger.
Offsides, it's the defense. Illegal formation, only six on the line, gets the offense, goes offset.
Wow.
Three paid it out.
Look at Ron Zook. Oh, brother. I know what I do in this situation, Dave. I give it to the man who gets me the yards. So far in this game, it's been the halfback just coming right up in there.
All right, no damage done anyway. No. It's still third down and one.
Just run for it. Don't get fancy. Just run for it.
Florida 4 of 9 on third downs today. Sean Wynn just lowers his head and picks up the first down. That's their fifth rushing first down today. Matter of fact, that's been the key to them on third down, is they've had some nice runs by Rand Carson, and now Deshaun Wynn seems to be getting into the act as well. Jim Tavis Walker. Not much happening for him as Justin Wade makes a big play from his linebacker spot. SEC football is brought to you in part by Toyota. Seven-point advantage for the Gators. Clock ticks at 2:36. Chris Leaks, who's had a nice day today, back to throw. Delvin Kite on the reception at the 20. Nearly broke the tackle of Vaughn Hutchins. He'll still be about 4.5 yards shy of the first down. Give him a gain of 5. The announcers for this game are selected and compensated by Jefferson Pilot Sports. This broadcast is a copyright presentation. Any use of this broadcast without the express permission of the Southeastern Conference and Jefferson Pilot Sports is prohibited.
Well, Dave, in this situation, you've got to get pressure on Chris Leak. Third down, about 4 to go. It's that in-between down. You know he's got to pass the football. Keep him in the pocket, cover short, get pressure on him. Bring somebody to help.
O.J. Small in motion. Leak, here comes some pressure. He gets popped as he lets it go. He got hit real hard from the backside. Pressure came from Charlie Anderson. That's his third quarterback pressure today.
Well, good pressure. You've got to keep on working. Defensive linemen have got to keep on working. See him right in here. Work, work, work. Just keep on coming. You get around the outside. You hope that your secondary can control it, can control and cover, gives you time to get around that corner, and that's what Charlie Anderson did.
Wilbert, line drive kick. Espy back. Will field it on a bounce. Breaks a tackle. Espy now trying to find some room and doesn't have any. But a pretty good defensive stop for the Ole Miss Rebels, and they have decent field position at their own 35. We will step aside in a 7-point game in Gainesville. Look at Max Starks on that bench. Max not 100% talking to Engel Martin. Also wired up, getting a little of that cool air through the back of that jersey. As Florida leads Ole Miss 17-10. Rebels will start from their own 33. Will play action. Manning going deep. Looking for Flowers. Hands him open. Caught at the 20. Out of bounds at the 8-yard line. Johnny Lamar on the coverage. But another big chunk of yardage for the Ole Miss Rebels.
And Dave, it was go all the way. There was never a fake. Flowers came off the line. He just ran a screamer down the sideline. It was going to no one else. Look at Manning. Look at him. There he is. And I mean, he's running just a streak go pattern using that speed. And what a great catch straight over his head. But a wonderful pass by Manning to lay it in. You lay it in and look at this, right over the shoulder. You just don't throw the ball any better than that.
A gain of 59 makes it first and goal for the Rebels from the 7. Here's Turner. Cuts it back. Puts it down to about the 6-yard line. Johnny Lamar with his 7th tackle of the afternoon. Ole Miss has been inside the red zone just once. This will be the 2nd time today. Their first visit resulted in a field goal in the opening drive of the game for the Rebels.
Well, David Cutcliffe doesn't want any field goal in this situation. He had 6 of them last time. He can't trade 7 for 3. He needs 7 points.
2nd and goal from the 6. Espy in motion on the near side. Manning to the middle, over the middle. Pass is incomplete. Chris Collins got popped right as he put his hands on the football from Darryl Dixon, the free safety. And that jarred the ball out of there, but Collins hopped right up.
Boy, when Collins got hit on this play, he's stretching for the football. Watch number 8 come in now. Watch Dixon. Bang! Just stick him right there. Pops the ball out. Now there he is, right there. Again, look at him come in there. Just as he was reaching to pull that football in, Dixon reacts to the play. You gotta love double D. They sure do here in Florida.
Timeout taken on the field with 15 seconds to go in the 3rd quarter. Back in Gainesville, Florida, a huge down for the Ole Miss Rebels. It's 3rd and goal from the 6.
Manning loves that post pattern. Throw that inside dart.
Receiver falls down at the 2. It was Ronald McClendon on his break, slipped in the pass. Oh, it looks like he might have cramped up as well.
He's going to be coming inside. You see, he just falls down right in there. He's down on the ground. Manning never sees him break. Throws it right to where he was going to be. But you got to get some points, and David Cutcliffe knows that he's got to settle for a field goal. Didn't want to.
Jonathan Nichols is hit from 33, missed from 52. And this is from 23. And it is up and it is good. Well, Jonathan Nichols missed his first field goal of the year from 52, but comes back and knocks it down from 23 yards. And we've got ourselves a 4-point contest with 3 seconds to go in the 3rd quarter. Hey fans, now is your chance to enter the Toyota Tundra Double Cab You Pick'em Football Contest. Just go online at jpsports.com, click on the Toyota banner to register and pick the winners. Weekly prizes will be given to the participant with the highest point total. At season's end, a randomly picked grand prize winner to be revealed on December 8th will receive a new 2004 Toyota Tundra 4-door D-cab truck. The Toyota You Pick'em Football Contest. Dave. 3 seconds to go, obviously, in the 3rd quarter. I got to feel like Ole Miss has got the momentum on their side. I mean, they give up some big plays defensively, but they've shut them down.
Yeah, they have shut them down. You ask me how good that defense was in the first half, you'll find out how good Ole Miss's defense in this series. And for Ron Zook, what he wants is his offense to come out, move the ball, move the chains, take some pressure off of his defense. This is the whole game coming down to this series right in here is going to be a huge series.
For the best deals on cars, trucks, and SUVs, visit your local Toyota dealer today. Lee Rogers will kick it off. Andre Caldwell, Kelvin Kite, back to return for the Gators. Hits at the 12, takes an ugly bounce, and Caldwell is popped right at the 10. That was an ugly kick, but it was very, very effective.
David, looked like a knuckleball coming down there and just died.
And that is the end of the 3rd quarter. We've got another good one. Ole Miss and Florida have played 3 quarters. We've got 15 more minutes of action coming your way right after this.
17-13, Gators on top of the Rebels as we start the fourth quarter. Dave Neal, Ed Zonbrecker, the offensive coordinator for Florida, Chuck Drisback, the defensive coordinator for Ole Miss, have gone against each other a bunch in their careers. The question is, do they stay with what they know, or do they try to fake each other out here in this fourth period?
I think Buzz will stick with what they know. And for Ed Zonbrecker, it's throwing the football deep. And a flag down at midfield, and the Ole Miss bench erupts. Burnell Brown is being tracked by Travis Johnson. And now the Ole Miss coaches say that was an uncatchable ball. Yeah.
That's what John Latina was saying. It's not catchable, but pass interference. But how about Chris Leak?
Pass interference on the defense. 15 yards from the previous spot. First down.
Chris Leak gets back there and just says, hey, I'm going to throw the thing long. I've got great receivers. Now, is this pass interference? It's interrupting his flight, but look how far the ball is, way over the head. I think that's what the Ole Miss coaches were saying. It wasn't a catchable ball.
Look at the penalties today. Total of 12 in this game. Had a couple of offsetting penalties that don't register, but yeah. We've seen quite a few flags today, mainly for the 6 men on the line of scrimmage. Here's Deshaun Wendt. Out to the 35-yard line. A gain of 9. Stats through 3 quarters. I never would have imagined that Ole Miss would be outgaining Florida right now, 380 to 322. It just doesn't feel that way.
And that time of possession certainly closed up quickly, too. But it's a big series here. If you're Ole Miss, you've got to think turnover. You've got to think stop, 3 and out. If you're Florida, keep on moving those chains.
Leak in the shotgun. Here's Wynn once again tries to turn the corner. We'll pick up the first down at the 40. Give him a gain of 4 on the play before McKinley Boykin brings it down. Ed Zonbrecker, the offensive coordinator.
You did enjoy talking with him yesterday, didn't you?
Yeah, he was great.
It was fun.
On the other side, the man, Chuck
Drisback. Chuck Drisback right there.
Defensive coordinator. Hey, that was your best telestration of the day.
Thank you, partner.
Thank you. You must have been really sad and staying in the lines coloring as a child. Here's Lee. Pressure comes. Gets rid of the football. Is it picked off? It is. Vaughn Hutchins with a huge interception at the 45-yard line. Pressure came from Jesse Mitchell. That might have caused Chris Leak to let it go a little too late.
Boy, Mitchell did get pressure on him. He's going to roll over to the weak side here. See Mitchell coming up on him, getting that pressure. Now he throws kind of off balance, but credit Vaughn Hutchins. Look at this, one-on-one coverage. Look at Hutchins playing his eyes. Now plant, look at the ball, and dive back inside. And the ball was late getting there to the receiver.
Second interception of the season for Vaughn Hutchins. Here comes the 90,000 Gator fans trying to cause some havoc. This is a big possession for the Ole Miss offense. Gain of 1 on the play for Jamal Pittman, the freshman from Columbia, Mississippi.
And Dave, now you're going right into the strength of Florida, their secondary. For Eli Manning, he's got to try to pick him apart. He's going to try to stay with that run game, see if he can pick up that 4 or 5 yards on first down, bring up that easy situation. But when you start to throw it, you're throwing into the strength of Florida's defense.
Ratliff, Dixon, Scott, Lamar, Corey Bailey. Second down, long 8 for the Rebels. Manning drops, fires. Wide open is Bill Flowers. That'll be an Ole Miss first down into Florida territory at the 41-yard line. Jarvis Herring makes the tackle.
Boy, and Manning, what Manning did is he read a 3-deep zone. You see, they're all playing zone coverage, and what Flowers does is just circle in that seam. Deep zone, short zone, he comes right in between it and is a big target. It's tough playing zone coverage against a quarterback who can read it and has that dart to throw it in there.
Clock ticks at 12:26. Timeout taken by Florida. with 12:22 to go in the fourth quarter. We've got a good one. Stay with us. Today's game is brought to you in part by Hummer. First and 10, ball on the Gator 41. Ole Miss, after the Von Hutchins interception, trying to put it in the end zone. They've had to settle for a couple of Jonathan Nichols field goals today. One touchdown.
Manning sees the pressure and calls an audible.
Play clock at 6. He had his protection right. He throws an incomplete pass, but he got people lined up and certainly protected himself. But Eli Manning today, Dave, not huge numbers.
No, but results. He's found SB deep. Great pass right there. Good adjustment in the pocket. He's gone to Collins and had success also. Again, moving around in that pressure and finding Collins. And then the big one that he hit the Flowers, that was just an outstanding pass. Laid it up right over his shoulders. That was as well as you can throw the football. He's having a good day.
13 of 24 for 212 yards. Second down and 10. Just a play action, buying some time. His fullback's open. And Townsend drops by Kewon Ratliff after a gain of a yard. That'll bring up third down and 9.
And that's not the situation that David Cutcliffe wants. That is the situation that Ron Zook wants. He wants his defensive line to come flying in there. If you're Eli Manning and company, you got to find something to make about 9 or 10 yards. Keep this drive alive.
Ole Miss third and 9. They are 3 of 9 in third down conversions today. Gators have done a much better job in that department than they did a week ago. Manning has time. Throws it out of bounds, and Eli Manning just will not take a sack. He's only been dropped 6 times this year.
Boy, great pressure that time. You come in there, Lester coming in there, they crush it down, they make the pocket small. Now just keep on collapsing it, keep on working it. Lester's got a hand on him, forces Manning to throw it outside.
Well, it's 4th down and 9. The Rebels have decided to go for it. Bobby McCray trying to get some heat on the quarterback. He had a couple of sacks last week against big Jerry Lorenzen. Would love one here on 4th and 9.
If I'm Florida, I'm going to come with the pressure.
Flag down in the Gator secondary. And the play clock stands at 00. And they're just going to move back 5 so they can punt it.
Yeah, that was just a hard
and
count.
The lay of gain on the offense. 5 yards. Remains 4th down.
And this is a good call. A lot of people would want David Cutcliffe to go for it. But this is a good call. You punt it, try to punt it deep. Your defense has played well today. You've held them. See if you can get the football via a turnover or 3 and out.
Cody Ridgeway to punt it. Turn it from the 9. Ratliff to the near side. Out of bounds at the 23-yard line. Give him a 14-yard return, about his average this year. And the Gators have it, leading by 4. We've got just over 11 minutes to play from the Swamp in Gainesville. 17-13, 11:01 to go in the football game. There's a longtime Gator football fan. Watching another good one in the Swamp today. An SEC East-West matchup. Ole Miss actually leads this series 10-9-1. They haven't played very often. Here's Rand Carthon over the left side to the 30-yard line. A gain of 7 on the play. Let's go down to Dave Baker with our all-tell sideline connection.
Dave, it was just a year ago when Florida came back after losing at Ole Miss. As soon as that game was over and the team got back to Florida Field, Ron Zook came out on this end zone, had a meeting, and said it was important not to lose the team. He said he was talking to his team Thursday night about the feeling when they tore down the goalpost last year, and he remembered most of these guys weren't here. They don't remember.
Good point. Grant Carthon certainly remembers it. Carthon to midfield. His longest run of the season from scrimmage. Give him 22 on the play.
Missed tackles. Travis Blanchard misses from first. Couple of missed tackles as he breaks through the line. I like his running strap. Little misdirection now. Come back inside. Pick up a block. Good block in there. Now there's one tackle in this. Picks up the yardage, Dave. That's your go-to guy.
Carthon with a career high 14 carries and 110 yards. The 110 is a career high. Sean Wendt. It's about three on the play.
You know, that's been a good blend right in there. Just Deshaun Wynn, just the freshman, with Rand Carthon. Freshman, senior, good blend.
Deshaun Wynn is physically imposing, and he's just a youngster. Here's our Hummer scoreboard. Virginia Tech winning. Minnesota storms back to beat Northwestern. Or that's late in the fourth, I should say. Over the middle, passes high, and it's intercepted. Intercepted by Travis Blanchard. It just got away from Chris Leak, and Blanchard was on the spot, his first interception this season.
Not too much pressure, but the ball just floats. And Leak knew it right away. Watch the ball just float. See how high it is? Over the head. You got to drill a dart in there. And that's one of the corrections that Leak was able to make last week in the second half. But this week, it just cost him.
Last year in Oxford, Ole Miss came up with four Rex Grossman interceptions, and that was the difference in the football game. Manning throws back. Here's Collins. He's got great speed. Collins at midfield. Collins to the 40 and run out of bounds, and a flag. Could be a hold against the Rebels.
Oh, that's holding. And it might be Shannon Snell. If it's holding, excuse me, not Shannon Snell, Bobby Harris. That is holding. That is a huge, huge mistake.
At that point, just get out of the way.
Oh, yeah, exactly. I mean, he's not going to stay with a cornerback. You've already disrupted the play. You've got positive yards. Boy, if that is huge. I know you're trying to make the effort. Lineman downfield, trying to get a block, working hard, but you just don't put your hands out and grab.
Should be a spot foul, I would imagine.
I think the question is it first down?
Holding on the offense, 10 yards from the end of the run, big first down.
That moves them back into Ole Miss territory, and they will be about a half a yard shy of a first down.
Let's see if we see number 75. There he is. Now watch. See, he's got him right there, but watch. He see it, puts his hands out on him. You can't do that. Again, right there. And when he cuts back, see the hands on him right there? You've got to let go of him.
Boy, if that was Cliff Woodruff, we wouldn't have to worry about it because he's got the big claw wrapped up.
Well, you know, you're trying to make that effort downfield. You have to credit him because he's 15 yards downfield.
Here's a unique situation. It's first and one. Hand off the left side. Into Gator territory. Tremaine Turner drives to the 46 before he's run out of bounds, and that'll be a first down for the Rebels.
And, Dave, you see that Ole Miss is running with a lot of vigor, especially Turner.
Let's check in with Buzz once again.
Dave, has this not been an impressive performance by this Ole Miss offensive line? John Latina was talking about when you move guys around so much, it can cause a lot of confusion. It looks like Florida's been confused on defense, and these guys have not subbed out. It is a brutally hot day down here.
They have really earned my respect this afternoon.
Absolutely. No doubt. Came out, they had a great offense. They've averaged over 500 yards in the last 3 weeks.
Play clock expires. And the Rebels will have to take another 5-yard penalty.
I think I thought Eli Manning went up and said they didn't reset.
Head ball, delay of game. It's the offense. 5 yards, Lane's first down.
Yeah, the Rebels tried to get the timeout, but our referee, Javon's not biting.
Nope.
So first and 15 from midfield.
Manning has enough experience to realize that you don't need it all on one down. Florida, they're going to play his eyes, see if they can step in front, get pressure on him.
Movement on that left side. Bobby Harris. And I wonder if Bobby McCray didn't make the move first into the neutral zone to cause the movement on the left side.
Come on, man. I thought that same thing.
Ball start. It's offense. 5 yards.
And that's what Ole Miss players are saying right now, but that's not the case. For all you young fans, SECKids.com is the place to be on the internet. You can learn about your favorite schools and athletes, and more importantly, play some really cool games. SECKids.com, the new sports website for kids from the SEC. First and 20 now. Gain of about 9 on the play, 8.5 on the play for Jamal Pittman, the 6'2", 240-pound tailback.
Dave, a lot of people might say, well, why is he not throwing? Why is David Cutcliffe not throwing? That's a good call. If you split him, John Latina knows, if you can split him, you can pick up 8-9 yards.
Well, here's the other reason. They've rushed it 26 times today for 201 yards. They've thrown for 233, have the Rebels. Delayed handoff to the left side. Johnny Lamar tracks down Jamal Pittman, a gain of 2. That'll be third down. And a long 10, 9.5 perhaps. Johnny Lamar today with 9 tackles for Charlie Strong's defense.
Well, if you're Ole Miss, you've got to make first down yardage. You've got to run the play 12, 15 yards. If you're Florida, got to get pressure.
Are you in 4-down territory now?
Well, with 7 minutes left on the clock, I think not.
Play fake. Manning hit from behind, loses the football, recovered by the Rebels. Bobby McCray, who turned it up in the second half last week against the Wildcats in Kentucky, doing the same here at home against the Rebels.
Well, Bobby McCray is number 57, and I want to tell you something. Right there, outside, watch him work. He's a big-time pass rusher. He proved it last week, and he just came up with an outstanding play. Get around, use that speed. Nobody questions his talent. They just said he needs to do it more often, but he's doing it.
Ridgeway punts it away. High kick, aiming toward the sideline. This one will bounce into the end zone, and the Rebels will have to play some defense now. Florida has the football. They'll have it at the 20. Boy, is it a good one in Gainesville. Stay with us. Work them silly, Gators, and that's what they're doing. They're making Ole Miss work hard. But, Dave, the Rebels have earned my respect today.
Absolutely. A team that had over 600 yards last week against them passing. They have played hard.
Somebody loses a helmet. Josh Cooper in to make that tackle. Here's our quarterback comparison today. Pretty similar numbers. Difference is 2 touchdowns for Chris Leak.
Absolutely. I see a lot of courage. You know, Chris Leak has got so much confidence in his ability. I mean, he's fearless back there. Just a freshman. I mean, last year he's playing halfway through his senior year in high school.
Leak to throw. That pass nearly picked off. Vaughn Hutchins, who already has 1 interception today, stepped in front of Carlos Perez, and it's just incomplete.
Well, pressure on Leak makes him throw this ball quicker than he wanted to. See the pressure coming right in there. But I'll tell you this, Vaughn Hutchins played this well. Look at him go up at the pinnacle, at the top of it, get those hands in there, fight the ball down.
That was close to maybe being a late hit on the quarterback. Third down and 13. Pressure coming. Leak scrambling. Leak at the sideline gets nailed as he lets it go. And an incomplete pass. And Leak, let's hope he's okay. He got really hit. Ben Troop wants a flag.
But you know why he's not going to get a flag, Dave? He's not going to get a flag because the defenders were playing the ball. But you're right. Leak gets stuck. He breaks that one there. Pressure coming in. He throws across his body right there, and he gets stuck. But Troop wanted it, but you see the defender going for the ball. Josh Cooper's the one who got the shot on Chris Leak.
Gators punt. Partially blocked. Mike Espy picks it up and gains about 9 yards on the return. Back-to-back kind of strange-looking plays, but once again, Ole Miss has real good field position. Florida's been backed up this entire second half.
Absolutely. I thought this ball got tipped. I thought you called it. Not sure that. Boy, it was close if it didn't get tipped. But good field position. You're at midfield. You've got 5 minutes left. I don't know if a quarterback I'd rather have in there than an Eli Manning in this situation.
That was Kerry Johnson who got a piece of that punt. Delay handoff. Jacobs. Inside the 40. That'll be a Rebel first down. Gain of 13.
This is that little delay draw play. It just comes right up the middle. You're going to see it right in here. Delay now. Just find the seam. Look at the hole there. Wow. Credit that offensive line.
The Rebels came in terms of rushing, averaging 151 yards a game, 8th in the SEC. Today, 212. Sean Pearson gets a couple on the play.
Now you want to be conservative with 4.5 minutes left, but you don't want to get so conservative that you put your offense in bad field position, having second down 8-9 yards to go. If you're Florida, come with pressure. If you're Charlie Strong, find somebody to get in Eli Manning's face. Ron Suck using the old voice out there saying, come on defense, give me one.
Down and eight. Manning over the middle. Collins to the 16-yard line. Daryl Dixon brings him down. A gain of 19 on the play, and the Rebels are knocking on the door.
Dave, did you see how much time Manning had there? He wanted to go outside, and he came back off. It wasn't a lot of pressure. It was late, but Manning sat in there, just sat in the pocket, looked downfield, and found Collins on that crossing pattern in between the zone.
The Rebels have racked up 465 yards of offense to 365 for the Gators today. First and 10 from the 16.
Well, here comes pressure. Oh, and he sees it.
And once again, the play clock winds down. I wonder if Eli has trouble finding that play clock.
I think he does. They're in the end zone, high in the end zone, and he just is not looking up at it.
First down.
You know, it's true. A lot of places, the play clock is lower to the field, and as he's scouring the secondary and whatnot, you really got to look up a little bit to see it. Mississippi State up by a touchdown against Vanderbilt. Georgia Tech leading NC State in the fourth quarter. Here it's a four-point Gator lead with 3:15 and ticking. The Gator defense has only yielded one touchdown today. Inside the 10 goes Collins. Johnny Lamar with his 10th tackle.
Well, you go to that short thing, and that's what Chris Collins is on that play. Not very good coverage. Look at the distance between here and here. You can't do that. You've got to play it closer. Johnny Lamar is a lot better coverage than that. There's Dad watching son saying, okay. Not a whole lot of motion. That's the way he played.
On second and 4. Handoff. Off left guard, Bashawn Pearson, stopped by Reed Fleming. He needed to get to about the 6, inside the 6 for a first down.
Dave, they have used this lead play where they lead inside, you follow your fullback, just put your head down. How'd you like that one, Archie? Shakes his head saying, yeah, I like that
good
one.
Good call. Good call, he said.
The old redhead from Drew.
Ole Miss has struggled with getting touchdowns inside the red zone. A field goal here doesn't do them much good with the clock at 2:17 and they're trailing by four. On first and goal, a handoff to the up back, gets a couple of yards. Brandon Jacobs moves it ever so closely to that goal line.
Now
clock runs inside 2 minutes.
And Dave, that's the one thing that you have to really be conscious of here. If you're Ron Zook saying, hey, if you're going to score, I want the ball back. But if you're on the other side of the field and you're David Cutcliffe, you're saying, hey, just let that clock keep ticking down. Don't score too fast.
Two timeouts available for each club. Second and goal from the three in the I formation. It's Pearson. Pearson down to the one. And the clock moves. 128, 127.
Boy, I'm surprised Florida's not calling a timeout.
Charlie Strong wants one. The defensive coordinator for Florida will use one of their final two remaining. Oh, my goodness. Stay with us. During the timeout, the entire Ole Miss dressed out roster converges to pump up the offense. The Gator fans trying to pump up their defense. Third and goal from the one. Touchdown, Rebels, with 1:11 to play. It's Jim Tate. Vashawn Pearson with the touchdown.
Nothing fancy, just blow him off the line, and David Cutcliffe loves it. Big man on big man, it's my favorite time. And Ole Miss won my favorite time. Unbelievable to drive that length of the field.
One after is up and good. And with 1:10 to play, the Rebels take a three-point advantage. Just last week, Texas Tech scored the winner on the Rebels with 1:04 to go on the football game.
How the hell did you get a job?
Look at this. Big man, just pushing out there. Just not going to be denied. That might get Archie to stand up. Yes. Now you call upon your defense. A lot of time for Chris Leak.
We'll step aside after a message from the SEC.
Ole Miss at Oxford, joined in poignant history and powerful words.
I was the writer in residence at Ole Miss from 1980 to 1990, and several of my students have written books, and John Grisham used to sit in on my classes.
Is it the words that capture the place, or the place that captures the words? Ole Miss at Oxford, where words come to life.
The Ole Miss faithful that traveled to Gainesville, right now happy, but there is plenty of time left. A minute 10. However, Florida has just one timeout remaining. Lee Rogers will kick off. Kelvin Kite back deep. This is returnable from the goal line. Kite to the 25. Losing some yards. Needs to get on the ground to stop the clock. 60 seconds, make it 59 to play. Let's check in a year ago. Ole Miss got one of their biggest wins in school history against the sixth-ranked Florida team. It was a defensive struggle as the Gators took a 14-2 halftime lead. But the Rebels would score twice in the third quarter. The second touchdown on a Matt Greer 24-yard interception return. Ole Miss held on to beat the Gators 17-14. Trying to hold on 20-17 now, but Florida from their own 22 out of the shotgun. Lee under pressure. He can run. Big spins to the 32. That'll stop the clock to move the chains with 49 seconds.
And that's as good as a timeout. Got to move the chains, as you say, Dave, stop the clock. Now you're going to find out the kind of quarterback that Chris Leak is. Can he find one of his wideouts? He's got that timeout. If they catch it over the middle, he needs to go out with his passes.
Pressure again. Leak throws it out of bounds. That'll stop the clock. Leak takes another good shot with 37 seconds to play in the game. Josh Cooper came up with some big pressure.
Yeah, absolutely. That's exactly what they did. They forced him out of the pocket, throwing across his body. It's not going to work. He's pulled the trick several times, so he just needs to stand back in there, stay in that pocket, and find one of his wide outs, move the chains, and get a timeout.
Second and 10. Leak has all day, goes up top. Picked off at the 25-yard line by Eric Oliver. The third interception of the day. Last year, the Rebels picked off Grossman four times. And that'll do it with 29 seconds to go. And Eli Manning has beaten the Florida Gators twice while Peyton was 0-for-4.
And Leak knew this when he threw it. He puts air underneath it. Look at that. He doesn't have the confidence that it's going to be completed. He looks and look at the reaction. He knew he floated the football out there. Can't do that in this league. They react too quickly. Now, just kneel down.
Dave, this is why college football, it's great. As Florida takes a timeout, we'll return.
Gather around the good stuff.
David Cutcliffe, a happy man. As Ole Miss takes a knee and Florida cannot stop the clock. This will be the first time Florida has lost in the Swamp in 58 games against an unranked opponent. But what a testament. As I said, this is why college football is great, Dave, because you're dealing with young men, and Ole Miss could have folded their tents up and not even shown up today after last week against Texas Tech. And, I mean, it was an unbelievable performance by David Cutcliffe's team today.
It really was. I mean, they were a wounded team coming in here. They lost all their pride.
Let's check in with Dave Baker.
David, you got a patchwork offensive line all dinged up, and you just ran it right at him in the second half.
Gutsy performance by our entire football team. Those kids made up their mind. They came down here to win, and they were able to do it.
You came close last week. You've come close on a couple of other occasions. This time you get over the top.
We talked about we didn't come down here to try to be close. Fortunately, our players made plays when they had to make plays. I'm real proud of this staff and the way the squad bounced back after a tough loss.
Congratulations,
Thank
David.
You.
Great victory. Back up to you, Dave.
Thank you, Buzz. Our Napa Auto Care Center's players of the game, Ronald McClendon with 107 yards on the ground, including a 52-yard touchdown scamper. Ben Troop for the Florida Gators, four catches, 64 yards, and a touchdown.
SEC football has been brought to you by Napa Auto Care Center. By Pizza Hut. By Bell South. By BC Power. And by Sonic Drive-In.